fucking beautiful thinking about how deep fighting games are in like retrospect. Like, you really focus on, if you're really trying to get good, like the really good people are distinguished, like, between, like, they're focused on fucking screen placement. Like, even like now it's become interactables. Like, dude, like, just there's so many little things that separate them. The metered management, like their screen placement, like not only in like footsies, but like where they like choose. These guys will like put their backs in the corner just to trick you, to get you in the corner. Like, shit, like so many fucking little beautiful things, mm-hmm. that like they're actually focusing on. And like they're telling me how bad my meter management. Why the fuck do you keep putting your like self in that situation? Like, dude, after you tech that, they're like, run up, you know, like, dude, gain, like, talking about screen control versus characters and matchups. Like, little did I know, like, I'm talking to Alex Valle, like, because I was on the fucking journey to get good, man. And I'm like, what are you looking at when you're playing against a zoner versus like when you're playing against a heavy rushdown character, and like learning a bunch of shit like that from the legends. Like, it's so beautiful. It's so deep. It's so, that's why when that simple guy said that shit about Sonic Fox, and I'm just thinking like, dude, little do you know how fucking God this dude's decision making is. Like, Sonic Fox, dude, like, only if he knew, like, only if that dude could fucking fathom how, like, the art that goes into it. Because it's hard. It's deep. It's some deep shit.
Absolutely. Like, dude, I was able to talk to Jimmy Rollins during this TBS show that I did January last year. And I equated fighting games, you know, martial arts. Yeah, absolutely. Being in that ring when you have to fight somebody and you're looking at the body movement, the movement they're making even before they move their body, like how are they flexing their hips differently? Where is their weight distributed? You're looking at those things, not even thinking about it. You're just like, what are the options where in the stance that he's in now, right? Mm-hmm. So all that's going through your mind. What's the next move? Am I going to counter? Where's my weight going to be? You all have to have that feeling. When you're in the batter's box for baseball and you have a fifth of a second to decide if you're going to swing the bat or not, if that ball is going to be a ball or a strike, or if it's going to hit you at freaking 95 miles an hour, you have to make that choice to swing or not. That choice, that repeated choice making over and over again in that very small window of time is what fighting game players do. They just have to continue to make those choices, engage, and not just the character themselves in the game, but also the player. How does that player play that character? What do they do 9 times out of 10 when they wake up?
You have to put such heart. It's weird.
Absolutely.
It's weird.
So people are like, well, this isn't a sport. Like, all right, they may not sweat, but the amount of mental fortitude, strategy, end game in order to be the best, bro. I mean, seriously, it's very incredible. And when I started to feel those feelings of correctly blocking strings and then punishing and knowing what that was, like, okay, after he does this, I'm going to do this move because it's only 6 frames. And I knew the concept. I knew what that meant.
I know.
I was like, I'm learning a new language. It was like I was learning how to play a new instrument, bro. Ooh. Fire and brimstone. I love it. I love fighting games for that reason. I feel so connected to them, even though I'm not the best at them. I think what I kind of play the best chill is shooters, for sure, because I've grown up on those, playing them. I like playing just shooters on console because it's just chill on my big 4K TV. But fighting games. Fighting games. Yeah, I know. Fighting games are my jam, bro. They're my bread and butter. It's when there's a number of times, like when I play Battlefield or Call of Duty, I'll get like a triple kill or something. Like, yeah, but when I win a match that was so close in fighting games, I'm like running outside the house. When I won that one set at Evo, that was real, bro. I was up against a Green Lantern that was kicking my ass. I was down 0-2, and then I came back and won 3-2 with a reverse sweep, and I just exploded, bro.
That was a great feeling.
It's one of the best feelings in the world, and that's why we do this. It's why people compete, because, you know, it's incredible.
It is.
It's an emotional drive.